Bayside friends, welcome to our Kidz Rock lesson.
Pheagle wanted to say a happy birthday to all our Bayside friends. We hope you have a wonderful and happy birthday. May God shine on you and through you. This week's Pheagle question. How many days did God take to create the world? God took 6 days.
Jump up and join us for worship song with Dan Warlow.
There is nothing our God cannot do. There is nothing that is impossible. No one is greater than the Creator. There's nothing our God cannot do. You spoke and it came to be. You made every star, every galaxy, the wind and the waves. Hear and obey. There's nothing our God cannot do. There is nothing our God cannot do. There is nothing that is impossible. No one is greater than the Creator. There's nothing our God cannot do. You walked on the stormy sea. You stretched out your hands on the cross for me. You paid for our sin, death didn't win. There's nothing our God cannot do. There is nothing our God cannot do. There is nothing that is impossible. No one is greater than the Creator. There's nothing our God cannot do. There is nothing our God cannot do. There is nothing that is impossible. No one is greater than the Creator. There's nothing our God cannot do. No one is greater than the Creator. There's nothing our God cannot do.
Pheagle and his friends have been learning more about the fruit of the Spirit. We looked at love, joy, peace, patience, and kindness. But today, Pheagle wants to share a special message with you, and he is super excited and can't wait.
Let's get ready for Pheagle Tales.
I'm JD. Soon, we're all going to be putting up Christmas lights all over the house, on the tree, if we can ever untangle them. But this week, we're focusing on other kinds of lights. Let's see if you can figure it out. Hey, Pheagle, where are you? Hey, mate. Do you reckon you can help me untangle these, please?
It's the light of mine, and I'm gonna let it shine. It's the light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. It's the light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine.
Hey Pheagle, weren't you supposed to help JD untangle these? You really are showing how to let your light shine, but it doesn't look very comfortable.
I don't think that's what it means when you say this little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. But actually, what does it mean? This little light of mine. What light? I'm gonna let it shine. Huh?
Okay, so we don't have a real light that we switch on our bodies. I think I'm starting to understand. Letting my light shine has a lot to do with Jesus and not so much electricity. However, let's do an experiment. Let's see how we generate light. There is electricity in our house where we just flip the switch, candlelight, torchlight from batteries, gas light on the stove, moonlight, starlight, and daylight from the sun. Maybe you can think of a few others.
Let's see how the sun generates light. And this is called solar power. Maybe in your house or even here at church, we have these big solar panels on the roof. And the sunlight comes in and it gets all this energy out of it. It creates this energy and it's stored in this little fuse. And that is what creates the light. However, the panels need to be in the sunshine to be able to be filled with the power from the sun. I think this is more in line with what the song means. So if we are filled with the power of God, we don't need to wrap ourselves in fairy lights. I think God's light just shines through us because we are close to God and we are filled with His power.
And we shine the light. How?
So we shine our light by loving God and loving our neighbors through acts of kindness. Can you think of a couple ways that you can shine God's light? Here's the other thing. In a normal light bulb, if this little fuse breaks, well then the light stops even if it still has power. So just like the light bulb, we have a fuse as well. Not a real fuse. It's the same. Remember that one time when Mum blew a fuse because we spilled on the carpet? It means you've lost your temper, became angry, frustrated, or just lost your peace.
So we've got to see our power. What happens to our light when... So if God is our power, what happens to the light when our fuse is blown, like this one? Like when we're having a bad day or struggling, does the light stop shining?
Well, that's when we really see God's light shine through us. His Spirit gives us patience and gentleness, love and kindness to really shine even when we don't feel like it, even when we are mad or sad. When our fuse is blown, God's light keeps shining in us and through us.
Jesus says in John 8:12, I'm the light of the world. Whoever follows me will not walk in darkness, but will have the light of life. That sounds cool, but what does it mean?
Just like the solar panels are charged by the sun, and these little lights have electricity running through them, our power comes from the Son of God, of course. You see what I did there, Son? Yeah, you can have these ones to hold on to. Thanks, Pheagle, for helping. Jesus is the source of light, and there is a battle going on between light and darkness. But Jesus also promises that whoever follows him will not walk in darkness, but will have the light of life. And that is the kind of light that keeps shining even when the fuse is broken, which means that the battle is already won, even when your fuse is blown. How cool is that, Pheagle? Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for who you are, and we thank you that even when we may blow our fuse, your light is shining in us. Help us to embrace your light in us, and help us to shine our light in our families, in our schools, and wherever we go, so that other people can experience your light of life. In Jesus' name, amen.
This weekend is a weekend where many of us kids just think about tricks or treats, but maybe you could also consider how you could shine the light of God in someone else's day. What are some ways that you could do that? You can have a look on Pheagle's Facebook page for some ideas.
Of course, you could have your own late light shining party, maybe dress up in fairy lights.
Or have a massive disco in your backyard. have some friends over, if you can, and have a sausage sizzle.
Whatever you do, have fun and let your light shine. See you next time.
Pheagle showed us how to let your light shine, but that is not actually what it means when we say let your light shine. So what does it really mean? We don't have a light inside our bodies that we can just switch on. No, it's all about our best friend Jesus, not electricity. But how can light be generated? We have electricity in our houses, where we can just flick a switch, candlelight, torchlight from batteries, gaslight on the stove, moonlight, starlight, and daylight from the sun. How does the sun generate light? Well, it's called solar power. The sun is the power source and shines on the little panels, and it creates energy. The panels need to be in the sun to be able to be filled with the power from the sun. The energy is then stored and gives electricity to this little fuse that creates the light. Sometimes the fuse breaks and needs to be replaced, even though it still has a power source. We can even look at ourselves this way. If we are filled with the power of God and Jesus is our source of light, His light shines through us because we are close to God and we are filled with His power. We shine our light by doing good things, loving God and loving our neighbors through acts of kindness. Then God's light shines bright through us. In a normal light bulb, there is a fuse, and if it breaks, the light stops shining, even if it still has a power source. You know what? We have a fuse as well, and sometimes it breaks. And then we say, a person blew a fuse. It means we had a bad day, or are just going through some big emotions. God is our power. And when we go through these situations, we really see God's light shine through us. His Spirit gives us patience and gentleness, love and kindness, to really shine, even when we don't feel like it, even when we are mad or sad. When our fuse is blown, God's light keeps shining in us and through us. In the Bible, it says in John 8 verse 12, I am the light of the world. Whoever follows me will not walk in darkness, but will have the light of life. Jesus is the source of light, and there is a battle going on between light and darkness. But Jesus promises that whoever follows him will not walk in darkness, but will have the light of life. And that is the kind of light that keeps shining even when the fuse is broken. It means that the battle is already won even when our fuse is blown. This reminds Pheagle of Samuel, a boy in the Bible. When Samuel was old enough, his mother Hannah took him to the temple to be in God's house and help Eli, as she had promised God she would do. In the beginning, Samuel did small jobs around the temple, but when he got a little older, God spoke directly to him. Samuel listened to God and grew into a great prophet, sharing God's message with others. Samuel was sharing God's light, his message, with everyone. He was an example to others by making good choices and always listening to God. From a little child like you to when he became an adult. But how can you shine your light this week? Pheagle says he's going to love God, pray, and read his Bible. He's also going to do some kind things for his friends. How about you? How will you shine your light this week? Today's activity is a Let Your Light Shine pray activity. Please get an adult to help you. Use these instructions and let the little light shine while you pray together as a family. You will need 2 AA batteries and a very small light bulb. Remove the plastic ends of each wire and then twist the metal ends together. Connect the light bulb to the batteries and let your light shine. Let's pray together. Dear God, by the power of your Holy Spirit, help us to be like bright lights shining the love of Jesus for all who see. In Jesus' name, amen.
We hope you have a great week, and people can't wait to see you next time.